Bankim Sardar College in West Bengal was established in 1955. It is affiliated under University of Calcutta. Our college offers undergraduate honors and general curriculum in 16 subjects that includes humanities, science and commerce stream. It also offers a postgraduate course in Bengali. Our main motto is enlightening students. During 1955, all sons of the soil were illiterate. Today, there are no first generation learners. Credit goes to our college. Student enrolls every year. We specially focus on empowering students. Information and communication technology and globalization has necessitated change in business and workplace. Therefore, today's students who are tomorrow's employees are now required to be more and more empowered with employability skills over and above being qualified with good degrees. That's why we provide employability skills by way of providing computer training, communicative English training, grooming and personality development, providing training for competitive examinations. We follow the rule of law. The college is administered by four sets of rule of law. We follow University Grants Commission regulations, Government of West Bengal orders and notifications, Calcutta University Statute, Governing Body Resolutions. Governing Body. The college is governed by a 12-member governing body as per the provisions of the Calcutta University Statute. Our government-nominated president, two government nominees, two university nominees, one Higher Education Council nominee, three teachers representative, one non-teaching staff representative, one student representative, and the principal, who is also the ex-officio secretary. As far as the financial matters are concerned, our college is recognized by University Grants Commission under Section 2F and 2LB and thus receives grant in aid from UGC as development grant. It is also accredited by the National Assessment and Accreditation Council in 2008 and 2015, and that too, that effect has deserved to be the RUSA Beneficiary Institute to receive MHRD grants. It is aided by the Government of West Bengal and to that effect receives granting aid for payment of monthly salary to all employees. It also receives tuition fees from all students and 50% of such fees goes to the Government of West Bengal exchequer as per government orders. Our geographical location. We are located in the Tangrakhali village. From Calcutta, by rail, it is 1 hour. The nearest railway station is Canning. It is only 4 kilometers and Taldi, it is only 5 kilometers. By road, we are 1 hour and 15 minutes away. Our nearest bus road is Canning-Barwipur Expressway. That is 3 kilometers from the location of our college. There are 102 islands in Sundarbans, out of which 48 islands are without any population and 54 islands are inhabited. Out of the total 4,500 square kilometers, 42 kilometers only have the railway line. 300 kilometers has the Pakka road network. Still, the area is the home of 3.9 million people, mostly who belong to various kinds of reserved categories. 80% of our students are from SC/ST/OBC families, 12% are from minority families, 42% are girls and 40% are from BPL families. All our students come from villages lying in the various areas of Sundarbans. 60% of our students come from the adjoining areas of Canning and Taldi, and 40% students come from the far off places like Shonakhali, Bashanti, Goshaba, Shojnekhali, Chorkhali. The only means of communication between the islands on the tidal rivers is through the waterways, poorly organized mechanized private boats. As per the UNDP report, human development of South 24 Parganas loses its relevance of these if these islanders are left out. But a model of rural development successfully executed elsewhere, might not be applicable in Sundarbans due to problems specific to this region with special geoclimatic characteristics. It calls for a deeper insight of the social and economic life of the people of Sundarbans. As far as the NAC recommendation is concerned, transport facility for students may be made available. As far as the attendance policy of our college is concerned, it is our sincere understanding that educational institutes become purposeless if students do not come to class. The college authority therefore set its priority and emphasis on regular attendance of students. Students not having 75% of attendance would have to repeat a year. Students not having 75% attendance will be ineligible to contest student union elections. Students who are irregular in classes would be barred from applying for students' stipend or scholarship as well as Kanyashree. Strict monitoring of class attendance of the students in the classroom across each period is maintained by the CCTV surveillance. Students' entry to the college is permitted only on exhibition of I-cards, which is also the digital I-cards, to the security personnel stationed in the college gate, and during class hours, no outsiders can enter into the college. The college has the practice of biometric-based student attendance management system, by which students' attendance in the college is tracked through biometric tracker and uploaded in an attendance portal named as dailyroster.co.in. The objective of this practice is to track class attendance of students through digital devices, wherein each student is provided with a digital I-card having barcode chip. Student entering the college would get tracked by the barcode scanner in the attendance in the college or class gets uploaded in an online portal which maintains the database from where appropriate attendance report can be obtained in accordance to customized search criteria. This is the uniqueness of the I-card, that the class routine of a particular student is embedded in the I-card in such a manner that if the student is not present in the college during the said class hour, the student will be marked absent on that day. Student in this college finds it difficult to come to classes, and the most important reason for this is that on the average it requires 40 rupees to 60 rupees for a student to commute to the college. What do the students feel about the strict attendance policy then? 24.9% students think that the strict attendance policy is correct. 65.7% students think that strict attendance policy is difficult to follow but still necessary. 1.7% of the students think that strict attendance policy cannot be supported, whereas 7.7% of the students does not have any opinion of their own. Students feel attendance policy is difficult because it is very much expensive to come to college. Therefore, they find it difficult to come to college regularly. The college is thus required to do something so that the student find it easier to come to the college. The college is thinking on that. It is very glad to know that our college is also the college with potential for excellence. The University Grants Commission, by notification dated 21st July 2016, has conferred the status of college with potential for excellence to 124 colleges in the country. Bankim Sardar College is one of these 124 colleges in the country. There are several CPE programs. Among them, the major programs are attendance, empowering faculties with use of ICT skills, department with potential for excellence, employability training offered to students. Throughout this period, we have come across various kinds of institutional empowerment and campus development. Institutional empowerment includes modernization of classrooms, modernizations of laboratories, building seminar halls, building student seminar halls, Wi-Fi enabled computer center with 32 terminals, language laboratories with 15 terminals, automated library reading room that constitutes up to 5,000 square feet. As far as the campus development is concerned, we are coming up with industrial training institute. The project is completed. Rain water harvesting project, 16,000 liters project, LED lightning project, 10 kVA solar power plant, and biodiversity park. There are other projects as well, which includes PC culture project, Campus Clean and Green Program and NCC Academy. We have our strength and potentialities. We are not afraid to think big. We have a sprawling campus of 33 acres. Our faculties are well qualified and our staffs are dedicated. Our part-time teachers have full-time involvement. Employees stay in the college for more than 6 hours. Sustainable financial stability. There is no students' union. As far as the subjects are concerned, we are marching ahead. On 2012, we came up with English Language Center. In the same year, the Computer Learning Center and the Boys and Girls Gymnasiums also set up. On 2013, two new subjects as English and Education were introduced. In the same year, we also came up with a power transformer, Wi-Fi enabled campus, online admission and fees collection, SMS gateway, biometric attendance, ICT enabled learning and online repository. In 2016, we introduced post-graduation in Bengali. In 2017, we set up virtual classroom, 4,000 square feet seminar library room and a seminar hall. In 2017, we also introduced the geography as a general subject. In 2017, we came up with solar power plant, modular biochemistry setup, modular electronics lab setup, modular physical chemistry lab setup. In 2018, we will be coming up with philosophy honors. In 2018, we shall also be coming up with English language lab, upgradation of computer lab, rainwater harvesting project, 1000 feet deep tube well for drinking water, medicinal plants project, fisheries development and training project, biodiversity project, NCC Academy, introduction of bus service from Sundarbans to the college. There are more. Stay tuned with us in video 2.